وصحبه حق قدره ومقداره العظيم. رضيت بالله ربنا بالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبينا ورسولنا. I actually feel ashamed to be speaking in front of two giants that we have in front of us, which is why I humbly ask for this forgiveness as we are their humble, as I am their humble khadim. There's an ayah in the Quran, in Surah Al-Furqan, a very powerful verse, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَيَوْمَ يَعَدُ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. On that day, referring to the day of judgment, that the oppressor, the man who will be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, biting onto his hand. يقول, and he will say, يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. And if only I took the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as my guide, as my pathway, as my friend. يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. And if only I didn't take so-and-so as my khalil, as my friend. لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ ذِكْرِ. Because this friend of mine, he took me away from the guidance I was under. وَكَانَ شَيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. And shaytan, he is deceptive with the people. And in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us who to place our trust with, who to place our loyalty with. Not to place our trust with the wrong people, not to befriend those who take us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this verse was actually revealed after a very interesting incident took place in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's a narration that during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was a man named Uqba bin Abu Mu'ayt. And this Uqba, he was from amongst the mushrikeen. And what he used to do is, he used to go out for business trips, and when he used to come back, if it was profitable, he would throw a big feast, a big meal, and feed the whole city. And this Uqba, as a person, he was always very listening to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to sit with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and even though he didn't believe in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was very kind to him, he was very respectful to him. So this one night, he had his big party, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he decided to go. So when Uqba, he came to serve the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he refused to eat. And then Uqba is like, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have to eat, you're my guest, you're not going to leave without eating. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I'll eat only if you recite the Shahada. So this doesn't mean that you go out and start forcing people to recite the Shahada. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was watching Uqba ibn Abu Mu'ayt. He realized that his heart was softening, that his heart was learning, was leaning towards the deen. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took this opportunity to propose the deen to Uqba ibn Abu Mu'ayt. So Uqba, he said, I really like what you're teaching, so why not? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad abduhu wa rasuluh. Allahumma salli alayhi wa sallam. So the next day comes, Uqba ibn Abu Mu'ayt, he's walking the streets of Makkah al-Mukarramah, and he bumps into his buddy, Ubay ibn Khalaf. And Ubay says to him, the word on the street is that you're not a Muslim. It says, you know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to my house last night, this is what happened, he proposed a deen to me, so and I accepted. So since now you're a Muslim, you're no longer one of us. You can't stay with us, you can't talk to us, you can't chill with us, you can't hang out with us. We don't know you, you don't know us, you're dead to us. He was basically kicked out of the clique. Right? And we face this every single day. We have this peer pressure, we have cultural pressure. When your brother decides to grow out the beard to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people, they make ridiculous remarks about him. Like they say overnight, did you see Abdullah? He turned into a Sufi sheikh. Our sister, she decides to wear the hijab. They say, you had a bad day, is that why you wear the hijab? People, they make ridiculous remarks. And especially here, living in America, being a Muslim minority, we face this every single day in terms of our clothing, in terms of our wudu, in terms of salah. What do? When we're in public and we have to offer the salah, what do? Do we ignore the frowns? Do we ignore the judgment? Do we ignore all these people laughing at us? So this Uqba, he was placed in this tough situation. What does he do? Because he's been boys with Ubay ibn Khalaf his whole life. That's been his boy since day one. So he doesn't know what to do. So he's like, so I want to pause here for a moment, because at this moment, Uqba, he's a Muslim, and not only is he a Muslim, he is also a Sahabi of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكُلَّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَ. That all of them, they promised Jannah. Uqba, he's seen the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he accepted Islam. He only had one foot in Jannah, but because of this pressure from his friend, he says, okay, I will disbelieve in Islam. I just want to be with you. Okay? So Ubay ibn Khalaf, he says, okay, just because you say you're not a Muslim anymore is not enough. You have to prove it to us. So he said, what do you want me to do? He said, we want you to go and spit on the face of the Prophet Muhammad. And there's two narrations, if I'm correct, what happened. He went and spat on the face of the Prophet and the Prophet, he wiped it off, he turned around and said that you made a very big mistake. And I believe there's another narration where when he spat at the face of the Prophet spit and halted in midair and shot back at his face, and he burned his lips, he burned his cheeks, and he was left with these burn marks until the day he passed. So the Prophet said, Ya Uqba, you had everything, you had Islam. He says, are you sure this is what you want? And he says, I made my decision. So the Prophet said, then your death will come outside of the city of Makkah to Mukarram. And who's the one who instigated you? He said, Ubay bin Khalaf instigated me. Then I will be the one who puts this Ubay bin Khalaf into the ground with my own hands. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. And in the battle of Badr occurred, the first Muslim battle. The Mushrikeen, they were gathering people to go to battle, and they stopped by the house of Uqba bin Abu Mu'ayyah, and he said, Ya Uqba, we need you to come to battle with us. And he said, I can't go. This man, he told me that my death will come outside of Mecca, so I'm not going to leave Mecca. So he said, take one of my slaves, take two of my slaves, they'll fight my place. And another man comes and says, Ya Uqba, don't worry, you have a red camel. And the red camel is like a Ferrari in those days. So he said, even if you do get in trouble, you can just run away with your Ferrari. So Uqba, he goes to the battle of Badr, which is Badr Allah Masha. Now this is where Allah's destiny occurred, and he was killed at the sword of Sayyidina Ali Karam Allah wajhul Kareem. And when the people, they walked by him, they said, this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophesied, that this man's death will come outside of the city of Makkah Mukarramah. And then as for Ubay bin Khalaf, I believe it was in the battle of Uhud, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told the Sahaba, if you see Ubay bin Khalaf, then let me know. The Sahaba, they said, there goes Ubay bin Khalaf. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he goes after him with a spear and shoots a spear at him. This was one of the only men the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ever killed. Even in battle, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he generally wouldn't kill. He would injure his enemy, and he would ask one of the companions to come and kill him. They would say, how bad is it for a person to die at the hands of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And this Ubay bin Khalaf, he was among one of the few people, and some of the historians, they say he was the only person the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ever killed. And returning back to the verse, he doesn't mention Ubay bin Khalaf, he doesn't mention Uqba bin Abu Mu'ayyah by the name, because the message behind it is very general. It's very general because sometimes we're guided, sometimes we have the guidance, but because we associate with the wrong people, we decide to be one of the cool kids. You know, we stray away from Islam, from the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we end up losing everything. We end up losing everything. So this is why we need to be aware of who we make our friends. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Al-deen, al-mar'u 'ala deen khaleelih," that you're on the deen of your friend. This is why we need to choose those friends who take us towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.